Data manipulation in R using DPLYR package. So DPLYR package is a grammar of data manipulation. It enables efficient manipulation of data with advantages of speed and simplicity of coding. So DPLYR is the package which helps manipulate data using available set of variables. It helps in enhancing the accuracy and precision of the data we are using. It is also known as data wrangling or data cleaning. So when we use the DPLYR package for manipulation, there is an operator that helps us to provide the formulas or functions to our data set. So it is called as the pipe operator. It is a percentage sign, then the greater sign and the percentage sign. So it creates a pipe symbol or the pipe operator, which passes data from the output of the function to the left and puts it by default into the first parameter of the function on the right. So if, for example, we are taking a data set and we are giving a piping operator. So the function provided here will be operated using the data set and the subset we have created using the function on the right. So the functions in DPLYR are summarize, mutate, select, filter, and arrange. These all combine naturally with group by function, which allows you to perform any operations by groups. So you can always summarize or select or filter your data using a group or conditions using DPLYR package. So let's first understand each of the function. So first is select. It is used to select variables that are columns. The function that is used in R is select function, which helps to select the column based on the conditions we will be providing. Next is filter. So it returns all the rows that satisfy a following condition. So the condition we will be providing, it will be returning rows as a result. Generally, it is used with relational or logical operators. Function that is used in R is filter, which filters the row based on the condition. So next is summarize. Summarize, it summarizes multiple values into a single value, which means the summaries are calculated by grouping observations using a factor or a categorical variable first. So whenever you want to calculate mean of your variables or the sum or maximum, any function that you want to summarize statistically, you can use summarize function for that. It gives best result when used along with the group by command. Next is mutate. What does mutate means? It adds a new variable and preserves the existing one. So if you want a new column to be added to your data set, it will help you to add a new variable or a new column, provided you already have some data with you, and based on that data, it will create a new column, mutate command. Then next is arrange. It helps to reorder rows by one or more variables. So we sort data into ascending order or descending order, and the function we use is arrange. So now let's go to R and create the commands. So the package that we are using here is DPLYR. If you are not having this data set, this package, so you can install it using package tab here, install DPLYR, or you can give the command install.packages to install the package name with DPLYR. So I already have this package. I am just loading it. You do not have to install it every time. You just need to load the command into your session whenever you are using that package. So the name of my package is DPLYR, and the command mignet within the brackets, name of the package name, it helps us to understand the package. So if I give this command mignet, so mignet helps you with the introduction of the package. So here there is introduction of DPLYR. DPLYR package makes these steps fast and easy by constraining your opinions. It helps us to think about data manipulation challenges. It is all about the package and the different formulas or functions we will be using in DPLYR. So there is filter or in select. It is about if it is, it will give you about each and every function that we will be using, some examples for that and the explanation for that. So let's load the library. So it says, and the following objects are masked from the package. Now we are going to start with our first function, that is select. For that I'm using empty cars data package, and I'm copying all the empty car data variables into df variable. So we will be converting the relevant columns of empty cars into factors, so that in further analysis and summarization we will be easily able to use factor variables. So for that I am first making a variable name, a vector with factor columns name, vector calls, and within that I am taking variable names as cylinder, transmission, then gear and carb. You can also take gear cylinder here. It is also factorial value. We have already taken cylinder, so let's execute it. So now what we are doing is we are applying a lapply formula, which will say to the df call. So we have added this column to df using the so we are subsetting our df data set, df subset the call name. So we are subsetting this data set using this vector and applying lapply function and saying convert all these vector variables into factor, into an ordered variable factor. So let's execute this command and check the values. So now let's check the structure of df. So you can see the factors, that the variables that we took in our vector, that was cylinder, transmission, gear, car, that is carbonator, they have been converted into ordered factors. So there are two levels of VS. AM is of two levels, then gears are of three levels, cylinder is of three levels, and carbonators are of six levels. Let's go further. Now what we are doing is we are applying sApply function. What will it do? It will return a vector with a different list for checking the frequency of each of the factor column that we created. So it is a kind of table. Like cylinders, there are 4, 6, 8 type of cylinders and the total count of the cars for each of the cylinder. Similarly for transmission, for gear and carbonate. Similarly for carbonators. Now let's go to select function. How we use that? It is very simple to use select function. The function is select. Then first we are giving this name of data set. So here I have taken empty cars. You can take df here. The name of our data set was df, and mpg, that means we want to select all the mpg rows, mpg column from df data set. Let's execute it. So you see there are all the 32 rows for only mpg column. Similarly, if you want to select using piping operator, so I have taken the name of data structure here, the data frame. I can use df here, then giving the function select within the bracket the variable or the column that you want to select. Let's execute it. I have saved this in A. It is the same output that we got earlier. So it is the column mpg and the number of cars. So it is 32 observations here. Next, what we are doing is we are selecting mpg cylinder and am column from empty cars using piping operator here. Let's see the first six rows using head command. So you see we have selected. So what we are doing is we are actually subsetting a data set using select command from dplyr package. So it is very useful and a quick and easy function to use whenever you want to subset your data. Then there is rename. So what does rename do? It changes column name and save it in same variable. So how does it, how can we use this? Suppose this is our data set that we are using, V, wherein we have three columns, MPG, cylinder and AM, that is automatic and manual transmission. So what we want to do is we want to convert the heading into uppercase name. So for that, the rename function, how do we use it? So you give the name of the command, that is rename. Inside the bracket, first thing you will give is the old name, the new name that you want, then the old name that you want.